So the banks will get you into a loan that you absolutely cannot afford. But hey, they just trying to make a dollar and they did that. They could care less about your finances, but let me sip this drink and mind my business. It's not tea, but it's hitting still. Let's talk about how twisted the banking system is and why you should not believe them and take out a loan because they calculated that you can afford it. Stick around, keep it locked. It's Crystal with the Cash Compass. If you're new, welcome. Thanks for joining the family. I call you fam already because I know you're going to stick around. You're going to like this video. So you might as well like the video right now and subscribe. Hit the bell if you're feeling frisky. Now, it's important to note that these banks make money off of interest rates, okay? They will twist and manipulate things to just make the loan so they can make their check. You see what happened in 2008. They was giving loans to anybody with a pulse. They were giving out what they call ninja loans, which means no income, no job, no assets. You was dead broke naked and getting a big ass house. Man, those were the good times. I need that right now. When it comes to protecting your financial well-being, you have to be in full control because they're trying to make a dollar. They're not your financial advisors. Please keep that in mind. Keep it close to heart. We're gonna talk about that right now. Now, when banks are calculating loans, and this applies for a mortgage, personal loan, any type of loan that you're taking out that's not revolving, they are only pulling and taking into account what is on your credit report, okay? What's on your credit report? Most times, it's really only student loans, car loans, mortgages, personal loans, credit cards. So you might be thinking, oh, that sounds like a lot, but it doesn't include a whole bunch of things that you pay for on a day-to-day basis. Things like gas, insurance, gym memberships that you know you don't use, Netflix and chill bills, phone bills, cable bills, brunch on Sundays, and the list goes on. And all those items can literally equal thousands of dollars a month that they're not even accounting for when they're putting you in that brand new car, when they're putting you in that fancy house. They're just reckless. So when you're getting a loan, let me tell you certain percentages that you should keep in mind as far as your wants, your needs, and your savings so that you can become fully prepared and have an idea of your own financial picture before you go in here and get lied to and manipulated by these people. See, I got you. I got us. If you are just starting out and things are kind of tight, maybe it's your first time getting a loan or something like this, make sure you have a good idea on how to manage your budget and how to increase your income, right? Because we need to spend less and make more. Shameless plug, if you have not watched my video on how to increase your income, watch that because I show you the tips that I use to increase my income by $30,000 in 8 months. So you're dealing with a professional here. So let's discuss how much you should be spending on what different items, okay? First category are gonna be your needs. And these are things that you absolutely have to pay to get through a normal life, right? Things such as grocery, housing, utilities, health insurance, car payments, and I'm also gonna add in any debt that you have because trust me, you're gonna have to pay that off. You will be screwed if you don't. So all those things are necessities, but this list serves as a foundation. You can adjust accordingly. Now, of your income, 50% should go towards your needs. 30% of your income should go towards these items. Shopping, dining out, any hobbies, any extracurricular activities that you may or may not be doing, your Netflix and chill, your brunch, all that stuff gets put into this at a 30% rate. And this comes from a chart that I found online, but I'm gonna show you why I tweak these just a little bit for better financial success. So we have 50 for your needs, 30 for your wants, what's the rest, right? Savings. They say 20% goes into your savings, but I think 20% is an absolute minimum. And even if you can't do 20, at least doing 10 is an absolute minimum. But I want to reach a point where my savings is increasing year over year, and you should want the same for yourself too. I want to work to a point where I've been making enough money that all my needs are taken care of with a small percent of my budget, and I can use the majority of my budget to save and to invest, because that's how we get to generational wealth, okay? And I'm working hard for my last name. I don't know about you. But at any rate, let's stick with the 20% for now, or 10%, wherever you're at. And this should be going into your savings. Now, I know I've said before that you should pay down debt. It depends on your situation. But ideally, if you've reached a point where you've paid down your debt and you're debt-free, definitely look and try to increase this amount as much as you can. Now, should you pay off your debt or should you keep a savings? If the interest on your debt is more than the interest on your savings, you are losing money by saving and not paying down your debt faster. If I lost you, write me in the comments. But make sure that you take a look and understand how much interest am I paying for my debt versus how much interest am I receiving? Does it make more sense to keep on earning 2% if my debt is at 30% or 20%? No, it doesn't make sense at all. Why don't you take a look at your own financial picture and see what percentages yours fall into? If you have some time, do this right now, make some time, figure out where everything is going. Where is the majority of your money being spent? How can you change that? How can you save more? Really sit down with yourself and get into this, because this is the only way you're going to get yourself out of debt, get yourself out of money struggles, and get yourself to a lifestyle where you're making decisions because you can, not because you're trapped and have a cloud of debt over your head. All right, that does it. If you like this video, then like this video. Be sure to subscribe. I post every single Wednesday, so tap that bell so you can see my posts. Watch some more, get your education up, and as always, keep your money up.